New York University study concludes liberals are delusional. A study was carried out by researchers at New York University that discusses how to turn a conservative into a liberal. Researchers found that when conservative people imagine they have superpowers, their views become more liberal. Serious folks. In the past, studies showed that the easiest way to turn a liberal into a conservative was to get them to understand the realities of life. But to do the reverse, you must get the Daily Mail Explains people to think delusional thoughts. The Daily Mail Explains. In the study, participants were asked to imagine that they had been given a superpower by a genie that made them invincible. With the superpower, even a fall from a cliff wouldn't hurt at all, Professor Barg writes. A control group was told that they could fly. The participants were then asked their opinion on political statements, including if they would be reluctant to make any large-scale changes to the social order, and whether it's okay if some groups have more of a chance in life than others. Results showed that the liberal participants' opinions on social issues didn't change. But the conservative participants who thought they were invincible started adopting more liberal views. In their study, published in the European Journal of Social Psychology, the researchers, led by Dr. Jaime Napier, wrote, "Results suggest that socially, but not economically, conservative attitudes are driven, at least in part, by needs for safety and security." Of course, we kinda already knew that. The liberal mentality is that you can sanitize the world of all its problems, specifically using government to do so. You often will hear liberals state, "We need to stop gun violence," or "We need to stop homelessness." They believe by forcing everyone into groupthink, that they can remove social injustice of any kind and create a world with no problems. In other words, they are delusional. Liberals compare the world to a perfect utopia where there is no injustice and everything is fair. The conservative mindset is that government has some items that it is real good at, that it needs to do to keep a society functioning in relative safety, but that life's hurdles are how we grow, and actually necessary. It is a biblical principle as well. Liberals' biggest delusion right now is that they are the majority. Democrats are struggling to win elections and have lost control of both Congress and the White House. Trump won West Virginia by 67%, North Dakota by 62% and Indiana by 56%. Trump won about 84% of the counties in America, Clinton won 16%. Only 26% of voters identified as liberals in Election Day exit polls, with 39% calling themselves moderates and 35% conservatives. Yes, Hillary Clinton won the popular vote by almost 3 million, but that's a highly misleading figure. It is based entirely on huge Democratic margins and a few coastal and urban enclaves. In California alone, Clinton gathered up a lead of 4.3 million, in New York, it was 1.7 million. Take away those two states and Trump's national margin was above 3 million. Yet liberals believe that everyone who disagrees with them are in the severe minority and that the far-left socialist belief permeates American households everywhere. But in reality, the bulk of their ideological friends are concentrated in a very few places.